So I gotta keep the rocket out.
You're the light, you're the night, you're the color of my blood. You're the cure, you're the pain, you're the only thing I wanna touch. Never knew that it could mean so much, so much.
You're the fear, I don't care, cause I've never been so high. Follow me to the dark, let me take you past our satellite. You can see the world you brought to life, to life.
So love me like you do, la la, love me like you do. Love me like you do, la la, love me like you do. Touch me like you do, touch me like you do.
What are you waiting for? Fading in, fading out, on the edge of paradise. Every inch of skin is...
found love in you. And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could.
Good evening, everyone. The Bible reveals our most important relationship is with the Lord when it says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. The next is between a husband and a wife. The Bible says, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife. And they will, the Bible says, become one flesh. Who gives this one?
I do.
Amen. Beginning, God knew it was good. It wasn't good for man to be alone. It caused Adam to sleep, took a rib, and brought completeness to his wife Eve. And Adam joyfully said, this is bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. Gerald and Asia, marriage is sacred. The Apostle Paul reveals marriage sacredness by comparing the relationship of a husband and wife to that of Christ and his church. Gerald, the Bible says, husbands, love your wives even as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. Gerald, God's path to joy and fulfillment in marriage is for you to love Asia unconditionally and sacrificially like Christ loved the church. Asia, the Bible says, to wives, wives, follow your husband's leadership as to the Lord. For the husband is the leader of the wife, even as Christ is the leader of the church. Asia, God's path to joy and fulfillment in marriage is to walk by Gerald's side and encourage him as the leader of your home. I am going to ask you both to make a covenant in the presence of those here today, but most importantly, in the presence of God, who expects these vows to be kept till death separates you. Do you, Gerald, take Asia to be your one and only wife, and do you covenant before God to love, comfort, and honor her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping your covenant pure so long as you both shall live? Do you promise? Amen. Do you, Asia, take Gerald to be your one and only husband, and do you covenant before God to love, comfort, and honor him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping your covenant pure, so long as you both shall live, do you promise? Amen. Gerald, what do you give tonight as a token of your love for Asia? Gerald, you will notice his ring is a complete circle. Without beginning or end, it is symbolic, I trust, of the endless love you have for Asia. Gerald, take the ring. Place it on the third finger of Asia's left hand as you place it there. Repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I come to you in marriage.
I come to you in marriage.
And with all my earthly goods.
All my earthly goods.
To you I give.
To you I give.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Angel, what do you give as a token of your love for Gerald?
You wouldn't be for real this time.
Asia, you will notice this ring is made of the purest of metals. It will not turn or tarnish with age. It is symbolic, I trust, of the purity of your love for Gerald. Asia, take the ring. Place it on the third finger of Gerald's left hand, and as you place it there, repeat after me. With this ring, I come to you in marriage. And with all my earthly goods.
To you I give.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So, Father, we pray that as family and friends, we might encourage them. And, Father, in ways that will help them to fulfill their marital destiny. And so, Father, bless this marriage. Father, we're excited about being a part of this occasion. And we lift them up to you in the beautiful, precious name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You may kiss your right.
Thank you.
is crazy. You find a way to make it right. Yes, I love and I love and I love and I want you. It's gonna be till the end of time. You only have to look my way for me to know it's not in vain. Against the tide. Yes, I love and I love and I love and I want you. It's gonna be till the end of time. I wanna be right by your side. I'm gonna love you day and night. It's only you that makes it right. Ooh. When everything is crazy, find a
y'all, those of y'all who don't know me, I'm Rashonda, an Asian peasant, obviously her favorite and her matron of honor. Well, when I found that I had to do this toast, I Googled a lot of things, you know, so I would make a fool out of myself and just be found in the moment. So it says you're supposed to start with a quote. So I'm going to quote the Bible. And it says, a man who finds his wife finds his identity. And Gerald, you have found our identity. Asia is very precious to us. Anyone who's ever been around her knows how she is. She is beautiful, she's loving, she's caring, she's honest, she's sincere, she's awesome. And you have found a good wife. So I know that y'all marriage will be long and prosperous. And I know that y'all have maybe a little cousins for me to play with and babysit. So I just want to take this time to raise my glass and toast to my cousin, my new cousin, Asia and Gerald. Congratulations, you guys.
So, Tim, can I tell you?
Please excuse me. I'm ready to have my phone out. So first, I just want to say good evening to everyone. For those of you who do not know me, I'm Timothy Samuel. Let me apologize in advance because I will have my phone out again. with that being said, I just want to thank everyone for coming out. And this is a good looking group. You guys look really good. Secondly, I just want to thank the parents, the Halls, and the seniors. You guys have laid a great foundation for these two. And you wouldn't be here today. They wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for you guys. Last, Asia, you look great. Gerald, you look all right. Nah, but seriously, you guys look great. Can we just give them all a round of applause again? So tonight I've been tasked with saying a few kind words about Geraldine Hall, or as you guys may know, Gia. You see, I've known Gerald for about 15 years now. I feel we met at a very pivotal time in my life because I had just transferred from Winsfield to Eisenhower. And I figured it'd be pretty tough going to a school in the mean streets of Aiken's home, or what you guys may know it as before four. Literally, I knew I was going to be a teammate that was going to be a lifelong friend, brother. Gerald, he basically took me under his wing, showed me the ropes, and we started to develop a good chemistry together on the court, and it spilled into our everyday lives. Until it was time to graduate, and at that point I decided to play basketball in Dallas. Gerald was off to San Francisco. What I believe at that time would be the end ended up being only the beginning. Because a movie by the name of Stomp the Yard came out, and I was convinced that I would need to transfer and join a fraternity. So I called Gia, we talked about it, shared some similar interests. And just like that, he had spotted me as one of his roommates at Aberdeen at the legendary 8103. And in Gerald-like fashion, again, he took me under his wings and showed me the ropes. That following year, he got ushered into the greatest fraternity known to man, Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. And when I say we had a blast, we had a blast. We went on road trips, spring breaks, and summers in the field was what you young kids call the day lit. We totally maximized our college experience. Bringing on to adulthood, our relationship continued to grow in a new direction. We found new love and food and travel, and we took pretty dope trips. But we took a very special trip, and that was to Puerto Rico. This trip, we had plans to introduce our wives to each other. And that's exactly, we figured they'd be cool kind of like us, and that's exactly what happened. Something very special took place on that trip. And it's something that we now share, what we call today e-board. But something else happened that day. I gained a friend, a sister, Asia. Asia is exactly everything G ever needed in a woman, wanted in a woman, and needed in a woman. And even though the both of them are never on time. You see, today, world's friendships come and go, but our friendship has stood the test of time. Gerald, you have been an unbelievable friend. You will build me every part of the way. You push me mentally, spiritually, and you make me look a lot better on the basketball court than I actually am. You know, G has been my point guard for as long as I can remember. If you know anything about basketball, a point guard has to make everyone around him better. He is an extension of the coach, the floor general. He sets the tone for the game, and he controls the tempo. And most importantly, he's the leader. So today is a celebration, because Gerald has now chosen a new teammate in life to point guard, to lead, and that's Asia. And believe me when I tell you, you got the best in the business. So a toast to the Hawks.
Alright, at this time, the bride and groom are going to do the cutting of the cake.
Thank you. Hey, boy! Yes, you can dance. You stood right beside me. Now you got your phone.